Hey everybody! For everyone who is immersed in the Tezos industry, we have a great news. Now you can explore Tezos and much better with our TzKT Explorer and its cool and useful features. In this video, we will analyze all the sections of the new version of TzKT and explain how they can be useful. First, block exploring. Here you can quickly see all the information about new blocks. By clicking on a block, you can find all the information about it, including rewards and commissions, as well as a full list of endorsers. There is a few good options you can view Baker on this page. Here are the buttons Next and Previews to easily navigate the blocks. Also, the priority and number of confirmations are pointed by color icons that allow you to better touch. If everything is green, then the block was baked on time and has the maximum number of confirmations. If it's red, then there were some problems in the network. You can also view raw JSON data for the block and for each operation. The data are loaded from the Giga node, an exciting product made by Tezos Ukraine. The second tab displays all the operations that are included in this block, as well as the information about them on the right side of the screen. So you can discover any information you need by a couple of clicks. A little life hack: if you are interested in a specific block, you can open it by simply typing its number in the search field, or even in the address bar. The next section, Accounts. The first tab shows all Tezos accounts with general information about them. Here you can see the account type, its delegate, when it's created, current balance, number of transactions, smart contracts, and the date of last activity. The list can be sorted by columns to find the richest one, the most active, and so on. For example, I just found out that more than 1,000 new accounts were created today, which may not be very useful, but it's very informative. However, as well as the list itself. Unlike BTC or Ethereum, in the Tezos account creation is paid by allocation fee, and therefore the number of created accounts reflects the real usage much more precise than in other chains. All because people do not spam new accounts. The next tab can be very useful in practice. Here you can see all the delegates, both public and private. In the list you can find the number of delegates, the stacking balance, the roles count and its share in the whole chain. Click here opens a list of dead delegates, with the last two columns changed to the last cycle and deactivation date. So here you can view all bakers, public, private and exchanges. Be careful that you can't delegate directly to exchange bakers, because this way they won't pay your rewards. The same applies to the private bakers. For more information, see our previous video. A couple of words about the trends in the baking. Every day, there are more and more bakers to come. And the more bakers we got, the less share the foundation has, which makes Tezos more diverse and independent. Then, here is a list of smart contracts with associated data, including the creator's account. Here, for example, we can see that the Atomix contract was created on July 8 last year and made 831 transactions over the year. You can open any of the contracts in the Better Call Dev by clicking on this button. A few words about it. We can say that if you're a developer, you will be delighted with this functionality that BKD offers. You can view all the information from the operation and the smart contract code and even conduct a simulation of interaction with it. We work closely with the BKD project and planning a mutual integration of the individual components of Explorer. The next item is a list of all Tezos tokens. The tab is similar to the previous one, but with the standards column. The token smart contract is also available for study in the BKD. In fact, there are only 3 tokens in Tezos. The rest, as you can see by the creators, are their test releases that were released and forgotten. On the token page, you can find the whole major info, total supplied and minted assets and complete list of operations and holders. One should say that there are a lot of new developers coming to Tezos. Big thanks to hackathons, and in the future we expect a lot of new projects and tokens. The next section, operation tabs filtered by type. First one is just a list of endorsers for each block. Then, the vote operations. Here you can see who voted, how, and who made the proposals. The list of activations may be interesting. As you can see, not all users have activated the funds received after the ICO. Almost every day several users perform activation. Double baking tab displays all accused cases. Who made the double baking and who received a reward for accusing. Here you can see the loss of the deposit, reward, and the hash of the transaction. Of the remaining items, we may notice the delegations and originations. This shows all accounts that delegate and redelegate their funds, and how much fee and gas is spent on this. Failed operations are shown in red. In originations, we see a large number of failed attempts to create KT addresses, which indicates the understating difficulties for a number of users and wallets. An amusing picture, it is obvious that the overall competence in the ecosystem needs to be improved. We've said this many times and working on it. Last but not least, a transaction tab. Nothing can hide from a sharp cat's eye. Here you can find a lot of useful information. Find out how much gas is spent for each transaction. Find out what commissions and limits users usually set for certain transactions, and so on. Similarly with the delegation, originations and reveal operations. All stats are in the palm of your hand. One more life hack. You can quickly copy the link in your account by clicking on this button. Or if you need to use the account address somewhere, you can only copy it here. Similarly, you can copy the hash and the link of any operation in the operation details. By the way, if the account is known, you can find contact information, sites, social networks, etc. for all known accounts, there is an autocomplete. By the way, you can just click on the search bar and drop-down list shows the most frequent and recent searching results. We make our Explorer convenient and user-friendly to make it as easy to work with it as possible because we use it every day. The last section shows the sequence of protocols and proposals. For example, you can view the status of the current Cartridge protocol and learn its details from the link in the Tezos Agora, where you can find the detailed description. For accepted protocols, there is a link to the documentation with a technical description of all changes. It is very useful for developers and for those who delve into the ecosystem of the Tezos and are not indifferent to its further development. All this data, and even more, can be obtained from our f***ing awesome AP. Or download and run our f***ing great indexer yourself. The indexer allows you not to only see this data, but also to build all sorts of statistics on it, such as daily volumes, etc. Soon we'll make a video guide how it's f***ing easy to do. See ya!